Hello, everyone, and welcome to another episode of Visual Studio Toolbox Extensibility Edition. We have been going through a mini series covering the new Visual Studio .extensibility model, what it is, how you can take advantage of it. And last time we talked about how you can implement commands, which are sort of the foundation of a lot of the extensions that you are going to be writing. And this time we are doing a deep dive into user prompts and notifications. So joining me today is Angel, who's going to share a little bit more about that. Hey, Angel.
Hi, Leslie. Hi, everyone. I'm Angel. So today I want to show you how to implement user prompts and a way to display progress for like a long-running background work in your VS extension.
Sweet. So just for clarification, what does that all entail, user prompts and notifications?
Yeah, so essentially a user prompt is just a dialogue that kind of let the extension show the user before they're like performing an action that's potentially expensive or important. So we want to double check with the user if that's something they actually want to do. So we want to provide like a little simple dialogue for people to see that they can either confirm or dismiss. And I can actually show you that in an extension I have prepared here. So what I have here is a Markdown linter extension running on Visual Studio. And there's one of the commands in this extension is called run linter on solution. So basically, that will kind of like run Markdown linter on every file in the solution. And because depending on how many files you have in a solution, that could potentially, you know, be expensive. So when you click on this, you will get this neat prompt that says, do you want to run linter on two files on this solution? And if you accidentally clicked on it, you can like dismiss it so it wouldn't actually perform that expensive action for you. And I also mentioned we have a way to display progress because this is, again, like could potentially be like an action that affect a lot of files. So when you click OK, there's this thing called Task Status Center in VS where it kind of shows the background work that's running. So if it's taking like multiple minutes, like user can click on that and see that that's the thing that's running in the background. So yeah.
Awesome. I'd say that's pretty important. I mean, I'd want to be notified before a giant. Like I think about the times where I have copied a large chunk of text and I'm about to paste it on accident. Like
yeah.
I appreciate those warnings where it's like, you're about to use a very costly paste action here, are you sure? I'm like, oh yeah, I just copied the entire book I was reading. I don't want to do that. So how do we implement that?
let's go for it. Okay. So yeah, what I'm going to demonstrate is like how we implement that, like how we implement the prompt and the way to display progress for the run linter on solution command. So as you can see here, I have this execute command async method. So within that, the process file async method is the method that actually does the action to run linter on all the files. Mm-hmm. So to implement a user prompt, we can go here, and then we'll use the context object to call show prompt async. And then the first parameter we pass in is a string. So we do like a string. I have a string prepared here for demo purposes. So this is a string that says, do you want to run linter on X files in the solution? I'll pass in an integer here. That's the total number of files to process. And then the next parameter we're going to do is called prompt options. So that essentially just lets you decide what kind of buttons, what kind of options you're displaying on that user prompt dialog. So in this case, we want OK cancel, but obviously there are many more that you can play with.
Can you have more than two buttons in your user prompt?
Yeah, absolutely. So there's actually a way to like implement your own custom options. So you can even define your own buttons on that dialog. So that would be pretty neat.
Sweet.
So yeah. Okay, so we have this method here. And since it's async, we'll await it. And then now this will return back a Boolean, which kind of indicates if the user has clicked on OK or cancel. So we'll check that here. And then we'll just wrap this around our method. And that's it. So that's how you implement a user prompt, just like that.
That's pretty quick. So in that case, if the user hit OK, then it's going to process all the Markdown stuff that was set up.
Exactly.
Sweet.
OK.
So about the progress bar, right?
Let's do that. So we'll still use the process file async method as an example. So because we talked about this could potentially take a long time. So to implement a progress bar when you're like running this action, you use the extensibility object. And then within that, there's a shell services and a method called start progress reporting async. And then you can give it a message. My markdown analysis message. This just says basically like run linter on markdown files in the solution dot dot dot. And then so here for the start progress reporting async method, we have two overloads. So you can use the simple default option where you don't let your users cancel that expensive operation in your extension. Or there's a more advanced option where you can kind of pass in a progress reporter options where you can pass in like, is my work cancelable, and set that to true. So that's what we're doing here. If you set this to true, that will display like a cancel button next to your progress. The user can do that.
But you can have the no turning back option if you want to. Like, whoops, you said OK, so.
Yeah. Well, that's why we had the user prompt to safeguard that.
Right.
So, OK. Oops. Let's finish implementing this. Sorry. Having some trouble with my scroll bar.
No worries.
It's like bigger than my usual right. display, you know?
Yeah, presenting the IDE is not easy on screen like this. Seriously, everything's been blown up so that y'all can see it better. So when we have to scroll, it's a real pain in the butt. So
right.
Hope you appreciate it.
Okay, so this will give you back a progress reporter object, and you can use this to call the report method on it. In this loop where you're kind of like running through linter for all the files. And the report method takes in a progress status object. So that's pretty simple to implement. I have like pre-implemented something here. But essentially a progress status object just takes in an integer that kind of indicates how many percentage the work has been running, and then an optional description message. Mm-hmm. So so I'll just call my create progress status method here. And then this takes in a file index, and then the total number of processing.
Cool. So in this case, we're basing it off of the number of files that have been successfully processed.
Yeah, exactly. And then additionally, you can also do something to actually cancel the work when user click on the cancel button. So you can use the cancellation token to call like throw if cancellation requested. And then we can like wrap this action in like a try catch, and we'll catch for like an operation canceled exception. And then you can do something to cancel.
Nice.
OK. Yeah. And finally, we want to return that progress object that we have defined just to complete the implementation of this whole method. And that's it.
Great. I love how straightforward this all looks. The naming conventions and everything, I feel like that is very easy to follow and understand, even mm-hmm. if I am learning up on it for the first time. And yeah, that seems really doable for creating something as important as a notification for extensions and stuff. So that's really cool to see.
Yeah. I forgot to mention something, actually.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
So the progress object, so to indicate that the progress has actually been completed for the
important.
Task center, you would want to dispose the object. So you can just add a using here, and that will dispose the object when it's done with it.
Cool.
So that's kind of important to know.
Yep. Yep, good to know. Awesome. So anything else before we conclude?
No, that's it.
Sweet. Well, Angel, thank you so much for sharing that. That is very important, and I appreciate just how simple that seems to be to get that set up for extensions. So if you want to learn more about user notifications and user prompts, then you should check out the VS Extensibility repo, right?
Yes.
Cool. So we've got relevant documentation for that, as well as code samples, all the things you need to get started writing your own Visual Studio.extensibility extensions. And also be sure to use the issues feature if you want to share your feedback once you've tried it out. So other than that, Angel, thank you so much for being here. This was awesome. I can't wait to add notifications everywhere in my extensions. It might just be something dumb why aren't you using this extension? If you don't use it in the next 5 seconds, we're going to do one of those creepypasta things from the internet.
Yeah, please do.
Sweet. So join us next time when we talk a little bit more about also Markdown Lensing, but specifically we're going to be talking about how you can utilize the editor APIs in your extensions. So until then, happy coding.